We have Eunice on the line. Hello, good morning to you, Eunice.
Yeah, good morning.
Right, thank you so much for calling.
Okay. Please, I want to ask counselor that.
Mm-hmm.
So, if you're in a relationship,
mm-hmm.
and you are dating another man again,
you are double dating.
If you're a lady,
mm-hmm.
and you have two guys dating,
okay.
Is it good? I know it's not good, but how connected is it? Like, how born it is?
Okay. Thank you so much for calling, Eunice. Counselor. Counselor will take that up. Counselor.
Sure.
Yeah, so I think with dating, I said it some time ago here, that Eunice, if you understand the principles of dating, that one, dating is not marriage. That's the first thing you must know. So when you are dating, you don't indulge in things which are meant for marriage. Like sex, investment, you don't invest in a person. When you understand the principle, then one of the rules is that you can date more than one man. But when you begin to see the kind of dating she's talking about, I know it may be the ones that people are already doing, that when I'm dating, I'm already sleeping with you, it's like we are married.
Mm-hmm.
When you do that, even doing it to one person is wrong, let alone doing it to two or more people. You understand? So as for that one, I would encourage it, and it's not good. But when you understand dating, as in dating, like I said, dating means you are still in the market.
Right.
You are not checking yourself where you don't have any intimate, you don't build bond yourself in any way, then you can date more than one man because you are checking yourself and you have to make a choice.
Okay, Eunice.
Yes, please.
Right, you heard counselor, right? Okay, so let me know your thoughts on this. What's your favorite Wizkid song? Hello, Eunice.
Yes.
What's your favorite Wizkid song? I want to give you a free ticket this morning.
When I said
okay, all right. Thank you so much for calling, Eunice. Okay, all right, counselor.
Yeah, so we need to have a better understanding. You see, my moral of blessed memory says something that when purpose is not known, abuse is inevitable. The reason we are abusing sex today is that we don't know the purpose of sex. Let me say this to everyone. I think I've said it here before, that sex is one of the things God created as prayer in marriage. Sex is a prayer in marriage.
It's a prayer.
Yes. And it is reserved for only marriage. Why? Because, I mean, I did believe in this scenario, that the fact that you can do something in an environment which is legal, when you take it outside the environment, it becomes illegal. When I become a bosser and the cameraman become a bosser, we can fight in the bossing ring, I can punch him, they will clap for me.
But counselor, there's another school of thought that says that you will have to check what you're buying.
Yeah, so with marriage, one thing people should know is that you don't have what you call sexual compatibility. We have what you call sexual commitment. I don't know if I should repeat it.
Please do.
Yeah, so I said we don't have sexual compatibility, we have sexual commitment.
Commitment. Explain that.
Yeah,
for
you
me.
See, and that God is why God designed us, he understands what he put in between our legs, and he now commanded that don't engage us in this before marriage. One, the reason is this: meet any woman who is a virgin. Listen, meet any woman who married as a virgin and ask her whether she's complaining or she has issues. No. Because she's used to only one thing, there's nothing to compare. The reason why today women are having issues is that.
Even if this.
God is why. That's why God connected it to your brain. That's why when you engage, you sleep with your husband for the first as a virgin and you feel pain, the next time he's coming, the mind will regulate and open up the place. God is so wise. So meet any woman who married as a virgin. She has nothing to compare. The reason why today we have women who are saying this thing is too small, this is too big, is that you have alternatives, you have things that you have checked. So you can compare to have big and small. God is wise. So we are having issues today because we felt, I mean, I normally use this example, that the one who built or manufactured this phone says that this phone is not water resistant. And you buy it and think, oh, it's my phone, so I can put it in water. Then don't be upset when you put it on its up, coming on. So sex before marriage, the one who designed it says, don't engage. He has a reason. You go in and not enjoy. Let me say this. No woman can stay in marriage when she's not sexually satisfied. No woman.
Counselor, let's talk to Abigail. Hello, good morning to you, Abigail.
Good morning.
Abigail, kindly speak up for me.
Please, I'm asking whether you can sleep maybe around with, like, the boy you are dating.
Please come again.
Can you sleep around, like, sleeping beside, like, the guy that you are dating with? Sleeping over.
Okay. All right. Thank you so much for calling, Abigail.